Well, the president's chief of staff is trying to clean up the president's comments over the weekend, reassuring top commanders at the Pentagon that Mr. Trump was not talking about them when the president talked about them and made this accusation against them yesterday.
I'm not saying the military is in love with me. The soldiers are. The top people in the Pentagon probably aren't, because they want to do nothing but fight wars so that all of those wonderful companies that make the bombs and make the planes and make everything else stay happy. But we're getting out of the endless wars.
You heard the president there. He accused the top people at the Pentagon today of going to war, in effect, to benefit military contractors. Joining me now, General Wesley Clark. He's a former NATO Supreme Allied Commander and now a CNN military analyst. General, thanks so much for taking the time this morning.
Well, first of all, I mean, the historical record shows that it's the military that usually is advocating against the use of force. If you go back and look at all of the examples going back even into the Vietnam War, it was the military who always put the go slow on it, everything since the Tet Offensive, at least. And so if you look in the 90s, the aughts, the military has always said, can't you use diplomacy first? Please don't put us in there. Do you understand what may happen if it doesn't work the way you think it does? So it's the military that puts the brakes on. But more importantly, top leaders in the military have to submit financial disclosure statements each year. This shows all their holdings of stocks. And anybody associated with anything to do with the with procurement or any activities like this, you can't own any defense stocks. So it's actually impossible. Now, two comments, Jim. Number one, we'd like to see the financial disclosure of the President of the United States, what his taxes are, where he has holdings. But this is the kind of thing that is characteristic of Mr. Trump's statements. He puts ideas out there that maybe crossed his own mind. Maybe that's what he would be thinking about if he thought he was a senior general. Maybe he'd think how to make money out of it. But the last thing in the world our senior leaders think about. They think about the risks, the risks of not accomplishing the mission in accordance with what their political leaders want. They know the difficulties, the disruption of the other programs. And finally, ask any of them who've been in conflict, like I have. It's a really unpleasant experience, personally, because rather than things going hammered from every direction.
They know the real cost of war.
I get fired.
So tell me the impact of this. This is the commander-in-chief standing there and saying, top leaders of the Pentagon, they want to send you, in effect, right, serving members of the military into war purely to make money. What is the impact of that on their leadership, on morale?
Well, I think first, you know, the idea that most of the troops love Trump, that's wrong. They're seeing through him for what he is. But that statement is damaging to the integrity of the military chain of command, because maybe some people lower down don't understand the way the senior leaders operate. So it's not helpful. For the senior leaders themselves, most of them understand that they've seen Mr. Trump at close range. They've followed it more closely than the people out on deployment. And so they understand this is characteristic. They're not going to put in their resignations. They're not happy. But this is one more thing that he says that drives a wedge between him and the military and veterans groups on which he's relying for his reelection.
It appears he's trying to drive a wedge as well between, though, rank and file service members and their commanders. And I know you stay in touch, though you're retired now, with members of the military at every rank. Do you believe such a wedge exists, such a difference exists?
Well, I don't think he's going to be successful in driving the wedge. I think he might like trying to do this, like with the military justice moves he's made. But what you find from the rank and file is they believe in the integrity of the military system. Most of them trust their commanders. Most of them believe that they'll never be sent into conflict unless it's absolutely the last resort. Most of them believe that their commanders will advocate and argue for the resources they need to succeed and to stay alive if they are committed. So this is not really going to have the kind of beneficial impact that the president thinks it might in terms of driving the wedge, but it will have an adverse impact on him. And by the way, it also hurts the country as a whole, because it reduces the credibility of our military leadership and our chain of command in dealing with foreign policy around the world.
Let me ask you before we go, you're aware of the story in The Atlantic that broke last week about the president's comments dismissing those who died in war as losers, and then other accounts of comments by this president in multiple other outlets dismissing service by these members or even their loss of life, plus the president's public comments dismissing someone like John McCain or Gold Star families in 2016. What's your reaction to that personally and professionally, hearing comments like that coming from the commander-in-chief?
Well, first of all, the comments carry a lot of credibility because, as you suggest, it's consistent with his pattern of statements and behavior over the last 4 years. It's a sense of betrayal, honestly, because when we raise our hand and take the oath to support and uphold the Constitution of the United States, we have implicit trust in the chain of command. When I was in Vietnam, a lot of people didn't like Richard Nixon. I was a company commander on the ground. I believed that Richard Nixon was going to do the right thing. If someone had told me, hey, Richard Nixon, he's just a cynic. He just wants to see you guys over there so nothing happens to him politically. He doesn't care anything about you. If you're a loser for having served, that would have really hurt. And these comments really hurt people who are in uniform today. Plus, they feel like a betrayal to those of us who have worn the uniform and have put our lives on the line for the country.